Welcome to Introduction to the course format for your online Math 091 or online Math 121 course. Once you register for the course materials, you only have to log in here at mathas.scottsdalecc.edu to complete any coursework. So once you've registered, you'll come to this site and log in here on the left. You'll type in your username and password and then select Force Image Based Math. I should mention that the course site works best using Mozilla Firefox rather than Internet Explorer. So Firefox is the recommended browser. So once we click Login, we'll see the course listed on the left. Let's go ahead and take a look at the online Math 121 course. And again, if you're in Math 091, the course format is almost identical. This is the course homepage. Notice at the top, the first link is for the announcements. This is the main way that I'll communicate information to you about the course. So it's important that you always read the announcements once you log in. So this is our first announcement, which gives important information about the course as well as the first due date in red. In addition to the due dates being posted in red in the announcements, you can also click on the course calendar here on the left. All the due dates are on Sundays and Thursdays at 11:59 p.m. The only exception to this is the final exam. Under the announcements, you'll find the discussion forums folder. This is where you'll post to the discussions as well as reply to your classmates. This is also where you'll find the math lounge, which is where you can post homework questions. This is a forum designed for students to help students on the homework. And then all the course content is located in the modules seen below. So if we click on, for example, Module 1, we can see that Module 1 has four sections. And then within each section, there are three subsections. And this is true for every module section. So if we click on Section 1.1, we have a link to the textbook, a link to the video lessons, and then a link to the homework. So if we click on the textbook link, it opens the appropriate section of the textbook, which you can read online, or if you wish, you can print or save to a drive. And then below the textbook link are the video links. These videos are all hosted on YouTube, and they're all less than 10 minutes. So if we click on a video link, again, it takes us to YouTube to watch the video lesson. It's important that while you watch the video lessons, you take notes just like you would in class. So again, after you've read the textbook and watched the video lessons, you're now ready to begin the homework. So if we click on the homework link, notice how this homework assignment has 12 questions, and a majority of the homework questions, you'll see this button here for video help. So if after reading the textbook and watching the video lessons, you still struggle on a particular problem, you can watch this video here, which will work a similar question to the one you're being asked in the homework problem. But remember, it's important to watch the video lessons before entering the homework because you will not find the links to the video lessons in the homework. These are only short example videos. So once we think we have the answer, we can go ahead and type it in here. Notice when I click in the answer cell, if the question requires any special symbols, or let's say exponents, once I click in this cell, if I click on this yellow arrow, it'll bring up the appropriate math symbols. As we do the homework problems, we get instant feedback. So for this problem, once we type in the answer, we click the Submit button to get instant feedback. The green bar here means we scored 100%, and the score is instantly recorded in the online gradebook. So for example, if we leave this assignment now, question number one will stay 100%. But if we do want extra practice, we can click on Try a Similar Question. And if we miss this question, we still receive 100% because we got the first question correct. Notice also, there is a link here to jump to answer. So for extra help, if we want to see the answer to this question, we can click on Jump to Answer. But notice if we do this, we get a warning that if we still want credit, we'll have to work a new version to receive credit. So again, it tells us the answer here, but then we can click Try a Similar Question to receive credit. Now if I close this section, Notice after the four sections in this module, there's an optional practice test, which is your best study guide before attempting the module test. If we go back to the home page, notice at the bottom of the page, we have a link here to the syllabus, online office hours, and additional resources. So as we progress through the semester, I will post additional resources, but notice right now, we have a link to the course syllabus, an online graphing calculator, as well as information about online office hours. At the very bottom of the course, we also have information about the midterm and final exam. So hopefully now you're familiar with the basic features of the course and you can begin making progress. I do want to point out though how important it is that you keep a math notebook where you keep your notes, homework, work, and test work organized, because the notebook is one of the best resources for this course. I hope you found this video helpful. I look forward to working with you.